At the end of the fiscal year, we will have to transfer the closing balance of the current year as an opening balance for the new financial year. So in this video, let's see how we can set opening balance in Odoo 15. So this is our accounting module, and you can find the accounting dashboard. And here in the dashboard, you can see here we have an onboarding panel. So here you can set up your chart of accounts and record your initial balances. And when you click on this review, you can view all the accounts available, all the chart of accounts available. And these accounts are pre-configured in Odoo. So these accounts are pre-configured depending upon the fiscal localization package that you have set for your accounting. So here you can go to configuration settings of your accounting module, and you can see here my fiscal country is India, and I have installed Indian accounting, that is Indian fiscal localization package. So from Odoo App Store, you can see your country's fiscal localization package. So here for India, you can see I've installed Indian accounting, then accounting reports. So you can find all the related modules in that package. And so when you set this for your accounting, according to that, you can view the chart of accounts. So here you can view those accounts. And if you want to create a new account, you can just click on this create button and you can provide the code of your account, then account name and type of account. Like you can see we have different types like assets, liabilities, equity, income, expense. And for your accounts, and here for your accounts, you can enter the initial account balances, that is opening debit and open credit. So here you can see I haven't added any opening balances. So let me set balance for these accounts. Like I have an account risk assets. So for this, let me set a debit 5,000. Then I have a bank account. So let me add a credit 600. So I'm setting a debit 600. And for this debtors account, let me add a 5,000 credit. Then I have a fixed asset. So let me set a debit 4,000. Then here I have internet expense. So if we add a debit of 4,500. So after setting the opening balance, now when you check the journal entry, here we can see Odoo have generated automatically a journal entry with a reference opening journal entry. So here for this entry, you can find the number, then date of the entry, and you can see the journal, it's miscellaneous operation, and you can see the total amount, it's 14,100. So a journal entry is generated in draft stage. So here you can see the journal with all the accounts and balance amount that we have set before. So here we can find for our asset account, that's a debit, bank account, there's a 600 credit, then cash 600 debit, And debtors, you can see 5,000 credit. Furniture, we have 4,000 debit. And Indian expense, 4,500. And also, along with these accounts, you can see an additional account that is undistributed profits or losses. So this is an automatic balancing line added by Odoo. So it is added because we cannot post an unbalancing entry. So using this account, we can balance the opening balance journal entry. Here we can find the balancing amount. It's an 8,500 credit. So can find the total amount here. And if you want to edit this entry and add more accounts, you can simply click on this add a line and add your account, provide a label, then you can add whether it is a credit or debit. So for these accounts, you can see label that it's opening balance because we have set an opening balance for these accounts. Then you can find the accounting date in the journal. Now, after adding everything, if you're sure with the details, you can save this and post this journal entry. So we can see from draft, it is moved to post it. And here we can also view the reconciled entries. And if you wish to reverse the entry or if you wish to reset this to draft stage, you can use these buttons. Now, let's see how we can manually create a journal entry. Suppose if you want to get some amount from different partners, in that case, you can manually create, you can click on this create button, and here we can provide a reference. And again, you can choose accounting date journal, and here we can add the journal items. So here I've added an income account, local sales, and you can choose a partner. Then you can add whether it is a credit or debit. Then we add another account. Debtors, the same partner. So you can say automatically it is added as a debit, which is used to balance this. Then let me add. Purchase expense. So there is a debit. Creditors can see. Automatically 600 is added as a credit. So now it is balanced. So suppose if you can see I've added a credit for this account and here we can find that it is not balanced. So for balancing this, you can add another account like we have undistributed profits or losses. So you can see automatically credit debit is added for this and now it is balanced. So in this way, we can manually create a journal entry and make sure that the journal entry is balanced. Otherwise, we will not be able to post the entry. Like suppose if I delete this and if I try to save this, you can see cannot create unbalanced journal entry. There is a difference that is 700. So again, you can add account. After balancing it, you can save and post it. So that's how we set opening balance. And now here we have reporting. So you can find partner reports and we have audit reports. So here, if we open a general ledger, you can find the list of accounts and its debit or credit entries. So here for cash account, you can see the debit or credit. Then here for creditors, debtors. And here, if you unfold an account, you can view the related entries. Like here, we have a bill. So if you click on this, you can view the journal entry. And same way as general ledger, we have partner ledger. So here we can view the report where we can see list of partners and it's their debit or credit entries. Along with that, we can also view the balance. So that's how we set opening balance in Order 50. And if you have any doubts regarding this video or related topics, you can add your comments below. And for more information, or if you are looking for any order implementation or customization in your business, you can send your request to order@sybrosis.com. And don't forget to subscribe our channel to get latest updates.